There are some bangers that you've just not heard in years. I'm like, Tom, how did you find this?
It's lovely to talk to you about Loki. It's just incredible. I can't wait for everyone to finally get to see it. Oh. How surreal is it being a part of the MCU?
It's very surreal. I mean, it's surreal on the one hand because, you know, there's so much excitement and such a huge fan base for the MCU. But then it's comforting on another level because knowing Tom and Wunmi a little bit from drama school, you know, you're in this epic world with these big comic book characters, but then you're also with your old friends from school. So it's sort of weirdly surreal and wonderfully familiar at the same time.
It's like getting the old gang back together. It's so lovely.
It is quite surreal. It is quite surreal because, you know, you accept a job because you're excited and I really do love like the MCU but then all of a sudden like you have to do like press junkets and fans are interacting with the show and you're like, oh wow, like I hope they like it. I really hope they like it. It's just when you're working on it, you're not thinking about the end, you're not thinking about how it's going to be received or this part of it. So it's quite extraordinary.
I can imagine. There are so many fan theories. Do you ever read any of those?
No.
You stay clear.
I don't even know where I would find them. I'm honestly like such a Luddite when it comes down to technology and I just leave it.
To be fair, I'm the same. With Loki, there's obviously time travel involved. I was wondering if you could splice yourself into any moment from the MCU and kind of go back and experience that, which moment would it be?
Ooh.
That's a really tough question. I think I'd love to be spliced into Black Panther, probably one of those great fight scenes from that movie. I really loved the fight scene with Chadwick Boseman and Michael B. Jordan, you know, in the water and everything. I think that would be, I'd love to be in one of those kind of epic fight scenes in Wakanda.
Oh, I would go to Black Panther. I think the moment that he and Killmonger are fighting in the water for the title, I think I would go there.
I mean, what a moment to experience.
I know what this place is. The timekeepers have built quite the circus. And I see the clowns are playing their parts to perfection. Big metaphor guy. I love it. Makes you sound super smart.
I am smart.
I know.
Okay.
Okay.
Sophia was saying that Tom's just a Loki encyclopedia. Obviously, he just knows everything. Is there anything that perhaps we don't know about him that may take us by surprise?
Oh my gosh. I mean...
he loves music and he it's like he walks around with a theme song for every scene like we're about to do, and he like sets the tone for each scene. Like he has the most eclectic music collection, and he can find the most random perfect song for each scene. I don't know how he does it. 80s, it'll be like instrumental, it'll be just percussion, it'll be like a whole heap. Like his spectrum is huge. His musical spectrum is huge.
I'd love to get on his Spotify playlist or something.
Oh yeah, in the morning as well, his playlists on the makeup truck are always a joy. There are some bangers that you've just not heard in years. I'm like, Tom, how did you find this? Like, oh, it's great.
You would always be sort of DJ, you know, playing a song that would be the perfect sort of mood setter for a scene or a big fight, you know. So he's a great sort of team leader in that way.
DJ Hiddelston, I love it. His part-time job.
Exactly. Yeah, he would love that, I think.
There's obviously so many secrets involved with Loki and anything Marvel related. How hard has it been to keep so tight-lipped? Because I imagine you must have friends and family that are like, just please tell me something.
Yeah, you know, I think my friends and family have all been pretty cool about it. I sort of just accept that I can't say anything. So I think it's if you sort of say a little bit, but then people want more. You know, if you just don't say anything at all, then, you know, people just, you know, don't know, really don't have anything to miss or whatever. So it's not been too bad. I mean, I think like Renslayer herself, she has to keep a lot of secrets. So it's been good training.
You hold all the power.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, that's the fun thing, I think, you know, and with the timekeepers, you know, who we get to see a bit more of as the show goes on, who are, you know, even that's who Renslayer answers to. So, yeah, the sort of power dynamics on the show are really interesting and constantly shifting.
Well, huge congrats on the series and thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you. This is Hits Radio.